In this video, we are going to solve the exercise from the last lecture about how to convert strings into data types. So we were left with the practice of using the weather data retrieval function to correct the output of this function, because as we saw, the observation here is a factor, the date of the observation, when it should be actually a date type, a time representation. So the first thing that we need to do is convert that to a string. We can do that with the ask character command. The ask character and passing the specific column that we want to convert. Let's attribute this to a variable. So now we have seen that we have to specify, using the command strptime, we have to specify the format of this date to convert it to a time. So we are going to use this strptime observed date, the variable that we created, then the format of this date. And if we take a look in the class that this is outputting, it's a POSIX. So let's attribute that to the variable itself. Date is equal to the, okay, now the date has the date representations of it. So next step is to replace this date representation in our data frame. So we are going to replace the column OB with the date. Okay, now let's take a look in the structure of the date. You can see that now it's a POSIX instead of being a factor, and that's an important step to us to be able to make statistics about this data set. As you can see, when I'm working with this data, I test every comment that I do and look if it's giving back what I expected, because it's a good practice to always test the comments that you create to see if the result is what you expected, instead of just testing when you wrote your whole program, and then it will be harder to you to find what went wrong. So my tip, or my programming tip in this case, is to test each comment that you give to the prompt to look if it's really what you expected. In the next video, we are going to take a look in arrays and vectors. See you there.